It's 97.5 WABB and our breast cancer request.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, we'll look for a total. We'll try to find the total within like the next 10 minutes.
Have you ever fed a lover with just your hands? Close your eyes and trust it. Just trust it. Have you ever thrown a fistful of glitter in the air? Have you ever looked fear in the face and said, I just don't care? It's only half past the point of no return. Tip of the iceberg, the sun before the burn, the thunder before the lightning, and the breath before the phrase. Have you ever felt this way? Have you ever hated yourself for staring at the phone? Your whole life.
Tell her we're right here with her, and you know, thank you guys for your donation, and thank you for helping spread the awareness about breast cancer, cervical cancer, all of it.
It's Styles and Q-Tip and that WABB Breast Cancer Request-A-Thon. It's going strong, man. We're trying to reach that goal, and we're getting there. Just got to keep getting your calls, keep getting your donations. Love hearing your stories. 438-97FM, 800-678-97FM. I want to welcome to the studio Lori from Breast Friends, where all this money is going to locally here, helping us out behind the scenes today.
Yes, thank you for having me here.
Welcome to the show.
She's a little shy.
That's all right. Lori's the same one that was dancing and everything else up front, man. She's been here helping out for a little while.
Well, let's get some of that enthusiasm here. Come on.
I'm a little nervous.
You're just talking to, you know, myself and Q-Tip. It's okay.
And wait a second.
Sure, it's okay.
You are a breast cancer survivor, and you're nervous about coming on the radio?
Yes, 9.5 years.
Get out of here. Get out of the studio.
Yeah. I'm more nervous about that.
Come on.
God is good. Taking care of me.
It's been a wonderful day, though. First of all, thank you so much for all your help behind the scenes today. I mean, it's priceless what you've done, so thank you very much, first and foremost. You had a great question we asked her off the air, and why don't we ask that over the air?
Basically, my question I asked Lori over the off the air. Okay, Lori's in Breast Friends, and the majority of the women that are in the group Breast Friends, where all the money that we collect today is going, are breast cancer survivors.
Yes.
You are a breast cancer survivor of 9.5 years.
Yes.
It's obvious that there are women listening right now that may know they have a lump in their breast. They may feel it. They may have checked themselves, like we've heard many times, you can check yourself, and don't want to go to the doctor to be confirmed of what they think.
Right. It's scary.
Obviously, that feeling that you know is going to come at you if you go to the doctor is not something you want to face.
Right.
So if you had to give tips on getting that step to go to the doctor, and what is that feeling like? Right. Explain it to us.
The first thing I would say is don't hesitate. Get right in. You need to get in. You need to get tested. Have the mammogram done. And nobody likes to hear the C word. We all think it's a death sentence, but it's not. Because of like stations like WABB and all around the world that help to collect money for research, there's a lot of treatments out there that are available. And there's a lot of people like the Breast Friends Foundation. We like to talk to ladies and help them, hold their hands along the way, encourage them.
You know what, and if I gotta go and compare myself, I'm very hard-headed when it comes to some stuff. And you can tell me there's all types of awareness and there's all types of groups for me that are going to help me.
Right.
And me personally, I'm the kind of that if it has to do with me, I don't care. Right. It's a decision I personally have to make, and it's that feeling. What is that feeling like if I was to walk in there and be told that there's a lump in my breast that could be breast cancer? What was going through your head right then?
Kind of feel sick. You feel like you've been kicked in the gut.
What
you feel like you're in a dream, and it's not real. The words that you just heard are not real. what am I going to do now? What are my kids going to do? I had a daughter that was 2 and a daughter, well, no, a daughter that was 4 and a daughter that was 7. You know, and I couldn't imagine them growing up without a mother. And so those kinds of thoughts go through your head. And it's good to know that there are people out there that you can reach out to that have been there and done that and can help you through, can encourage you and let you know that there's hope out there. When your hair is falling out and you've lost a breast and you feel like you're not as much of a woman as you used to be, there are people out there that can hold your hand and walk you through that and let you know you are beautiful.
Tasha Bedingfield, actually, leaving a voicemail, basically. And any of you that have already donated, and if you donate, you're going to be in the running to qualify to come in here and get to meet and watch Natasha Bedingfield tomorrow. So that's cool, too.
La, 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 la. If you strip me, strip me.